हेलो फ्रेंड्स, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल। इन लास्ट क्लासेस वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज पाइथन, व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट वर्जन्स आर देयर इन पाइथन एंड व्हाट फीचर्स आर देयर इन पाइथन, ऑल द थिंग्स वी कवर्ड। सो इन प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट व्हाट इज पाइथन and what are the different versions are available in Python and what features we have in Python and all the things we discussed very clearly. Today I'm going to talk about, as per today class, I'm going to talk about prepare first Python application, how to prepare first Python application. I'm going to develop first Python application. Here, to develop Python applications, what we require. First, we have to install Python software in our system. After that, only we can able to write the Python program and we can able to execute that program. First, here what we have to do? First, we require to download Python, and install Python software. Otherwise, take like download and install Python software. Second activity what I am going to do is write and execute Python application. Here we are going to do two activities. One is a download and install Python software. Second one is write and execute Python application. Right. First, let me go to first activity. First, download and install Python software. Right. Before downloading and install Python software in your system, let me check in my system Python is already available or not. In my system, Python is already available or not. How we can check Python is already available or not? See, go to this start. Here, if you enter Python, py. So here you will get, otherwise, just give IDLE. So here, IDLE Python 3.7.3 is available in my system. IDLE means it is a Python related one only here, that is already available in my system. And other alternative way we can check, open command prompt. In command prompt also just give like Python --version. Otherwise just enter Python. Here if it opened shell editor, means Python is available in our system. So here, if it opens a shell, Python shell editor, means Python is available in our system. It won't take this much of time, and actually my system, I have so many software, that's why it is taking. See, and here you will get three greater than symbol like this, and this is the Python shell editor. And you are getting like this means Python is already available in your system. Python is, see, Python 3.7.1 version is already available in your system. Next, what we have to do, go to environment variables and check path is available in our system or not. And go to environment variable and any setup is there related to Python in our system or not. Go to environment variables. Properties. Advanced system settings. Click on this advanced system settings. Here, click on this environment variables. Right here, path. Check any path is available. Edit, click on edit. One minute. Go to control panel. First, I will delete from here. Here, you can able to see programs and features. Program and features. Here, I am going to delete my Python from my system. I'm going to install freshly and I'm going to install latest version. First, I will delete from here. Right here, check anything we have, which is starts with the P. Python 3.7.1 is there. Uninstall. I'm uninstalling this end. I will do freshly. Right, so it is uninstalled. So now open command prompt once again. Exit. So now here just type Python cl. Python is not recognized as an internal or external command. Python is not available in our system. So now let me go to here. Here also you can check IDLE. IDLE is not available at here. IDLE is got deleted and IDLE is not available at here. See, you won't get IDLE at here. 1 minute. Here it is coming up. See, so the item, it's not available and it's not available at here. So now I want to install. I want to install freshly. And for that, what we have to do? Open browser. Open any browser. Open browser. Here just go to Google. And here just type download Python. Download Python. So you guys will get like this at www.python.org. www.python.org. This you guys will get this one. Click on this one. Click on this one. So you guys will get like this. You guys will get like this. Here, Python latest version is Python 3.8.3. Latest version of Python is 3.8.3. And here, what we have to check. Right, we have to install any software based on our operating system. Here in your system, what operating system is there, accordingly you guys have to select. So now if you guys want to install on a Windows operating system, looking for Python with different OS, Python for Windows, Linux, Mac, like this we have different things in. So now click on this Windows. So you guys will get like this. Here what we have to select, download Windows is x86-64 embedded zip file, and here one more thing, Python 3.8.3 executable CND, this one we have to install and download Windows x86-64 executable installer we have to select, not zip and. Here two things are there, zip file and installer. We have to select this installer. Download Windows x86 64 bit and. Right. So suppose if you guys are, if a system have 64 bit and if you install 32 bit software, it will support for both and. It will work in both environments, 32 bit environment and 64 bit environment also. But here, if your system is 32 bit, but you are installing 64 bit, at that time it won't provide support. If your system supports 64 bit, then you can install 32 bit also. It will work in 32 and 64 also.
But if your system supports up to only 32 bit only, even if at that time if you install 64, it won't provide support. So here before installing, you have to check your system will support for 32 bit or 64 bit. Right now here I'm installing Windows 64 bit executable installer. Click on this. Send it is getting download. See, and here it will get download like this, and Python 3.8.3.exe file you guys will get it. .exe file you guys will get it here. Completed. Now go to that location. Here you guys will get like this. Python 3.8.3. Right here you guys will get a .exe file. .exe file you guys will get it here. So now what we have to do? Double click on this. Double click on this .exe file. Double click on this .exe file. Here, meanwhile, I will note whatever we did till now. Here, first step to download Python. To download Python, which website we have to go? CN. Okay. Here, what we have to do, you will get like this. Whenever you double click on the .exe file, you will get like this. Here, click on run. Click on run. Like this you will get it. Install Python 3.8.3 64 bit. We downloaded and now I am going to install it. Install Python 3.8.3 64 bit. Select install now to install Python with the default settings. Here two things are there. One is install now and the second one is a customize install. install now, and second one is customize install. Here select install now to install Python with the default settings. Default settings means in this location it will install. In this location it will install with the default settings. Or choose customize to enable or disable features. Suppose if you don't want all features, if you want to disable some of the features at the time of installing, or if you want to enable the features at the time of installing, then we have to go with this customize installation. Here two things are there. With the default settings you can install, then you can go for this customize install also. Right here I am going to click on this customize install. And one more thing, here install launcher for all users recommended. Okay, this one already by default selected. Second one is add Python 3.8 path. Here inside environment variables we have to set the path. Here if you are not select this button, if you are not select this checkbox, what it will happen? You have to set the environment variables path explicitly. That where we have to set the inside system environment variables, there we have to set the path explicitly if you are not selected this one. But if you want to set that path by default, here we have to select this one. If you select this one, what it will happen? Automatically it will set the path inside environment variables. Otherwise we have to set the path explicitly. We have to set the path manually if you are not selected this one. So please select this one also. Now here I don't want a default setup, I want a customized installation. Then click on this custom installation. Here what you will get at the time of installing Python software, what you will get? Documentation you will get, pip version you will get, and here IDLE you will get, Python test suites you will get, py launcher you will get, and all these things you will get it here. All these things you will get it here. And if you don't want anything, unselect those things. And if you want all those things, keep it like this only. Next, so this is the location, this is the location where your Python is going to install. This is the location. If you want to change the location, you can able to change it here. And here advanced options. See, and here you will get Python to environment variables. See, automatically it will set the Python and add Python to environment variables and create a shortcut for installed applications, associated files with Python. Everything you will get. Everything you will get it here. And this is the location where Python is going to install. If you want to change the location, you can do this one. So finally what we have to do, click on install button. I'm not changing anything, and by default I'm taking all the things. And right here click on this install button. See, meanwhile I will note it down the step set here. Right, to download the Python, which website we have to go? To download the Python, which website we have to choose? And this is the website which we have to go. Copy this one. And here I am taking. Go to https://www.python.org. Next, what we have to do? Next, what we have to do? Here, click on downloads. Click on downloads. Next, what we have to do? Select Windows x86 64 and 64 bit we required. Executable installer. Executable installer we have to select. And first what we have to do, we have to go with this website, and the second we have to click on downloads, and the third select Windows x86 64 executable installer link. Next what we have to do, right, it will get downloaded. Whenever you select this one, it will get downloaded. After downloading that, double click, go to that location. Go to downloaded folder location. Next, double click on Python 3.8.3 AMD 64.exe setup file. We have to double click on that. So next step what we have to do. Next step what we have to do it here. Select install launcher for all users. Here you can select anything and customize or install launcher, anything you can select it here. Here select. If you want to change the location and all the things, go with that customize. Otherwise by default, install. Install launcher for all users. Here what you will get, by default selected, that one already by default. So next what we have to do, select add python 3.8 to path checkbox we have to select, and select add python 3.8 to path. So next what we have to do, click on next button. Click on next button. Next one. If you want, you can change the location. Otherwise, click on install button. Click on install button. These are the steps we have to follow. First, we have to go to this location. So there we have click on downloads button, CND. Here click on downloads button. You will get like this. And here what we have to do, click on downloads button. Next, select Windows x84. See here, if you click on this, you will get this like this. And you will get all those things like this. Okay, it is taking more time. Leave it. See, and here select Windows x86 64 executable installer link. Here you guys will get like this. Here what we have to select, this one, and Windows x86 64 executable installer we have to select, right? So next, to do download, right, to go to downloaded folder location. once the download once download is completed, go to that location, folder location. Next, double click on Python 3.8.3 .exe setup file. Select install launcher for all users. It is by default selected. Next, select add Python 3.8 to path. Next, click on next button. Click on install button. These are the activities we have to do it here. These are the things we have to do it here. Right? Right. Installation completed. Setup was successful. Setup was successful. Close this one. I'm going to close this one. And so now let me check once. Is it installed or not? And go to this command prompt. Now just type like Python. See, ideally 3.8.64 bit, 64 bit came. If you click on that, so you will get like this. And Python got installed successfully. If you are getting like this, means which version? 3.8.3. And Python 3.8.3 is installed successfully. So now go to command prompt once. That here Python iPhone version. See, Python 3.8.3 is available in my system. Now I want to go to Python shell editor and Python CN. So now we came to this > shell editor. So now Python is installed successfully in my system. And so now what steps we followed to install Python? First, we have to go to this location, www.python.org. Inside that, we have to click on downloads. Next, we have to select Windows x86-64 executable installer link. It will get download Python in your system. A .exe folder will get downloaded. So now go to that location and double click on that setup file. So next, select install launcher for all users. By default it is selected. So next, what you have to do, just you have to tick mark, and you have to put tick mark the checkbox and add Python 3.8 to path. Click on next button and click on install button. Right, Python will get installed in your system. Clear? Any explanation is required about this installation? Right. So now once Python got installed in your system, what next I am going to do? Here I am going to write a Python application. Right. Where you are going to write the Python application? Right. We have multiple places. In multiple places, we can able to write our Python application. Right. So by using first one, by using Python provided IDLE. Inside IDLE, we can able to write it. What is the abbreviation for this IDLE? What is IDLE? Integrated Development and Learning Environment. Integrated Development and Learning Environment. Integrated Development and Learning Environment is nothing but IDLE, which is provided by Python. By using Python provided IDLE, we can able to write the Python application. Next option. By using Python shell in command prompt by using Python shell in command prompt. By using Python shell in command prompt, we can write Python programs. We can write Python programs. Next one, by using Notepad plus plus or edit plus some other editors we can use to write Python program. Right, next approach is by using PyCharm IDE. IDE means integrated development environment IDE, in the sense by using PyCharm IDE also we can write the Python programs. So these are the different ways we can write the Python applications. By using Python provided IDLE we can write, by using Python shell in command prompt we can write, and by using Notepad plus plus or edit plus some other editors we can write, and by using PyCharm IDE also we can write the Python program. Here this edit plus is the licensed version, and this is not freeware. You will get only 14 days or something free version, and try right here. By using these four ways we can write the Python program. We can write the Python program by using these four ways. What four ways are there? First one, by using Python provided IDLE, by using Python shell in command prompt, by using Notepad plus plus R, edit plus or some other editors. But here edit plus, if you want to go with edit plus, right, it is the licensed version. It better to use Notepad plus plus for Python and up to Python programs. Once we start Django things, we have to use some IDE like this, and PyCharm IDE like this we have to use. So now one by one I will show all these four ways. First let me go to this by using Python provided IDLE. If you want to use Python provided IDLE, what we have to do, just go to here and type Python IDLE, otherwise just give IDLE. So you will get like this, and you will get like this IDLE Python 3.8 64 bit, like this you will get it here. Just click on this one, you will get IDLE like this. It will open IDLE like this. So now here, right, print welcome to Python classes, otherwise that's it. Right, just click on enter button, you will get welcome to Python classes. Right, whoever having idea on Java, in Java if you want to execute any Java program, what we require, compulsory main method is required. Inside that, from that main method only execution will start in Java. Right, but coming to Python, there is no main method set here and there is no compilation yet here. Directly we can run our program. Here there is no main methods, there is no compilations. Directly write your statement and click on enter button, you will get the outputs like this. Suppose if you want to find out sum of two numbers, then what we have to do, nothing is there. Here A is equal to 10 I am taking, B is equal to 20 I am taking. Finally here A plus B, it will return 30. Here there is no main methods and there is no compilation. Directly we can run and we can write the program and we can run our application. But if you go with the Java, compulsory main method we have to take. Inside that main method only we have to do all operations. The execution will start from main method only inside Java. But coming to Python, we are not using any methods. Here we are not using any curly braces. Here we are not doing compilation. directly we are writing the program and we are executing that program it here. Right, like this, Python, this is the Python provided IDLE. From Python provided IDLE, we can write the programs like this. We can write the programs like this. See, here A is equal to 10 I am taking. Now here I am going to write one condition. If A double equal to 10, if condition I am writing like this, and here print true, otherwise here like this it will return true, and like this it will return true. Here I am writing one condition, if A is equal to 10, just print it true. Like that I wrote the program. Here A is equal to 10 only, that's why it is returning true. Like this we can write Python programs by using Python provided IDLE. This is the IDLE and integrated. What is IDLE? Integrated development and a learning environment. This is provided by Python, and by using IDLE we can write the Python programs like this. So next one, and right, this is one program just to print welcome to Python classes. This is one thing to find out sum of two numbers, and this is one thing to check the condition, and to check the condition this is one more thing, and right, like this we can write the programs by using Python provided IDLE. Next, by using Python shell in command prompt, how to write the program by using Python shell in command prompt. Just open this one, and open command prompt and type Python like this, you will get this one, and open command prompt and type Python, you will get this Python shell editor in command prompt. You will get Python shell editor in command prompt. Here also we can write the Python programs, and print welcome to Python classes. Just click enter button, you will get welcome to Python classes. This is the Python shell in command prompt, and I opened Python shell in command prompt. There I am writing the program. Print welcome to Python classes, you will get output like this, welcome to Python classes. Next, here also I want to find out which, here I am going to take two values. In that, which one is the bigger value I want to print, and so for that what I am going to do, a is equal to int input of enter first value, don't worry, I will explain all these things, and here I am entering first value, which is 20. Next, b is equal to int input of enter second value. Here enter second value, it is asking, I am giving 50. Now here I am going to write the condition. Here I am going to write the condition like, if A is greater than B, then what I want to do, I want to print like, print A is greater than B. A is greater than B, I want to print like this. Okay, what is the problem? Indentation problem. Right here, see, like this we have to take, already I told indentation, right? Print A is greater than B. Greater than B. take like this, right? So else here I am taking like print b is greater than a, like this I am taking it here. So like this I am taking it here. So now what it will print? 50 is greater than a. 50 is greater than a, and here what I am doing, I am taking a value and b value from the keyboard. If you want to take any values from the keyboard, for that input function we have to use. I will explain all those things, don't worry. Here I am taking a and b values from the keyboard, and here I am writing condition. If a greater than b, then just print a is greater than b. If b greater than a, then just print b is greater than a. Here I am taking the values. 50 is the b value, 20 is the a value. 50 is greater than b, it is printing. Right, so like this we can write the program. We can write the program in a Python shell editor. Python shell in command prompt also we can write the Python programs like this. Understood? Second approach is writing Python program by using Python shell editor in command prompt. Like this also we can able to write it. We can able to write the program like this also. Second approach also completed. By using Python shell in command prompt also we can write the Python programs like this. What is the third approach? By using Notepad++ or Edit+ also we can write the Python programs. By using Notepad++ or Edit+ also we can able to write the Python programs. So here I am going to open the Notepad++. In my system I have Notepad++ is there. I am opening this one. If you want to write the Python program in Notepad++, what we have to do first? Here we have to take one Notepad++ editor like this, and here we have to write the Python program. Just I am going to write like print welcome to Python and Django classes. Like this I took it here. Right, here already I told and semicolons are optional in Python, but if you go for Java, semicolon is mandatory at the end of the statement. Right, coming to Python, it is optional. If you take or not take, not an issue it here. So now, right, after writing the program, what we have to do? We have to save this file. Control S, we have to save this file. Right, here we have to save with the .py extension. .py extension, we have to save the program. So now here I'm going to give like python sample I'm giving, and here save as type .py, right? Here select .py, you'll get saved python file. Select this one, right? So now we have to save with the .py extension. Save this file. Where we are saving, I am going to save inside desktop, otherwise here on top of desktop I am going to save it here. Right, so next what we have to do? Next, after saving the program, next what we have to do? We have to go to that location, right? We have to go to that location where we saved on disk desktop only, we saved it. Go to that location, desktop. Here we have that program. Now here, open command prompt on desktop, and here I opened command prompt on desktop. See, desktop. So in on desktop we saved the program. So what is the name? Here we have to give python sample.py. Here python sample.py. See and welcome to Python and Django classes we are getting. What is this Python sample.py? This is the our program name only. Python, we saved the program with this name only. Python sample.py. Here we have to take some people will get py and some people will get Python and. Here I will try with py also. Py. Python sample.py. See, py is not recognized in my system and at the time of installing some people will get Python and some people will get py and I try with both and I don't know what you guys will get. Some people are getting Python, some people are getting py. In my system I got Python like this and python sample.py. So if you run like this, if you execute like this, you will get welcome to Python and Django classes. Here whenever we typed Python, whenever we typed Python, how it is recognizing and see py is not recognized as an internal or external command. Here whenever I give the Python, how it is recognizing based on environment variables. Based on environment variables we set in a path and we set one path inside environment variables, right? Based on that path it is recognizing this set, right? At the time of installing we tick one checkbox set. We tick one checkbox. Add Python 3.82 path. Add Python 3.82 path and see here you guys can able to see. See this step and it is that see this one and select the add Python 3.82 path and here some path, some environment variable path is right. See here you can go to the system computer properties. Here you can able to see it. Based on that only it is recognizing whenever you type on Python. So here advanced system settings and here environment variables and here you can able to see it. Here you can able to see path name and path. Here we have path like this. Edit. Copy this one and here see and in my system so many things are there and Java is there, Python is there, so many things are there. That's why here you are getting these many things and inside C drive users and app data local programs Python is there 3.8 Python 3.8 is available. See and how we got this one and because of selecting that checkbox. Because of selecting that checkbox, add Python 3.8 path. Because of selecting that checkbox, we got this one and up to here and right, recently we did this one only. Because of selecting the checkbox only, we are getting this one and from here it is taking that Python. If you are not set this one, if you are not select that checkbox, if you type Python, it can't able to recognize. In command prompt, if you type Python, it can't able to recognize it. Here it is recognizing in the sense what? Based on this environment variables path. Right here, for Python I have path, next one and see. Here, for Java, JDK 1.8 also I have in my system. And Atom IDE also is there in my system. And PyCharm IDE also is there in my system. So for each and everything it is right, it is setting environment variables path, right? So because of the checkbox only you are getting this one. If you forget to click on the checkbox, you won't get this path and explicitly you have to do this one if you are not select that one. And right here if you are not set this path in command prompt, it can't able to recognize what is Python, what is py. Here it is understanding, it is recognizing this one means what? Because of this environment variables path only. Clear this one? See, in my system, here we don't have py. Here we don't have py, that's why here py is not recognized as an internal or external command. Here we have only Python, that's why it is Python is recognized. Clear? So like this, we can write the Python program. Where in a notepad plus plus or edit plus or anywhere, right? If you want to go with edit plus, a license must be required. But for notepad plus plus, license is not required. Happily, we can go with this notepad plus plus, right? What is the last one we have? What is the last one we have? By using PyCharm IDE. By using PyCharm IDE, you guys have to install PyCharm IDE. And if you install PyCharm IDE in your system, you guys will get like this. And PyCharm Community Edition. PyCharm Community Edition, you guys will get like this. And if you install PyCharm in your system, inside this PyCharm also we can able to write our Python programs, right? So now I am not writing any program inside PyCharm. It will take more time. Taking more time means not for writing the program and to open this PyCharm, right? It will take more time. So now I'm not opening that one. Tomorrow I will show, right? So these are the four ways we have to write the Python programs. In today's class, what we discussed, how to install Python in your system and what are the different ways we have to write the Python applications. What are the different ways we have to write the Python applications? And so these are the steps we have to follow to write. These are the steps to follow to install Python. And see here. I'm going to put this one in chat window. Take this one and. In today's class, what we discussed, how to install Python in our systems and how to write the Python programs and what are the different ways we have to write the Python programs. Here I am going to use a Notepad++ to write the Python programs. Once we move into Django, I am going to use PyCharm IDE or Atom IDE. PyCharm IDE or Atom IDE, anything we can use. And Visual Studio we can use, PyCharm we can use, Atom we can use, multiple IDEs are available and we can use anything, right? For up to Python programs, I'm going with this Notepad++ only. Clear? How to install Python in your system and what are the different ways we have to write the Python programs? Clear? Any explanation is required? Clear? Please respond. Any explanation is required? Right. So just now I shared these points in the chat window. Follow those steps and install Python in your systems and try all these programs and try with the all these programs, all possibilities. And we have total four ways are there. Right. Exclude that PyCharm. Remaining three ways, practice once. What remaining three ways we have? Python provided IDLE. Second one is Python shell in command prompt. Third one is Notepad++. Notepad++ or Edit+ or Notepad, anything we can use. Right? Right. From now onwards, tomorrow onwards, I'm going to write small Python programs also. Clear? Okay, guys. We'll continue in the next class.